In the previous video, we discussed how to create and edit static interest areas and how to use them as templates for other similar trials in the viewing session. In this video, we'll discuss dynamic interest areas. So if you need an introduction to the basics of interest area usage in Data Viewer, please see the other video on working with static interest areas first. Dynamic interest areas are like static interest areas for the most part, with a few notable differences. Static interest areas contain information about the ID, boundaries, and label, and can optionally have an onset time. Dynamic interest areas, on the other hand, can be thought of as a series of instances of static interest areas, each of which has both an onset time and an offset time. As such, dynamic interest areas can change position, size, and shape as the trial progresses. Let's talk about how dynamic interest areas are organized first, then we'll discuss how to create them and use them as templates for similar trials in the viewing session. Each dynamic interest area consists of a set of one or more instances. The overall dynamic interest area has one ID and label, and each instance consists of boundary information, a start time, and an end time. The boundary information for each instance is specified in the same way as that of static interest areas. So, a dynamic interest area is kind of like a series of static interest areas, which all have the same ID and label. Since each of these instances of the interest area can be different in terms of their boundary specifications, the interest area can change size, shape, and location over time. Each instance, like static interest areas, can be a rectangle, ellipse, or freehand shape. Importantly, the start time and end time values of each interest area instance are specified in milliseconds from the start of the interest period. Creating instances of interest areas relative to the start time of the interest period not only locks the instances to the onset of the experimental event defining the interest period, but also allows you to create the dynamic interest areas once and then apply them to similar trials within and or across participants, and in the process ensure that they align temporally with those experimental events in the other similar trials. So, that means the first step in the process of creating and using dynamic interest areas should always be to set the interest period properly. I've got some data from a video experiment that was created in Experiment Builder opened here. This project sent a different message to the EDF file at the time of the presentation of each frame of the video. I'll use the message for the onset of the first frame of the video as the interest period start time message text, and the message for the blank screen that appeared when the video ended as the interest period end time message text. It's critical to do so to ensure that the timestamps for our interest areas will be based on a zero point that corresponds to the onset of the video. This will be important when applying the interest areas to other similar trials within or across participants. Next, we should group the data based on a variable that identified the video that was used on each trial. This will make it so that once we create the interest areas for a given video file, we can quickly apply them to similar trials in the viewing session. Once the interest period has been set and the data have been grouped properly, there are several ways in which you can create the instances of dynamic interest areas. You can use a manual creation method, a copy-paste method, a couple of variations of the copy-paste method, and a mouse record method. Let's go through how you can use each of these methods so you can see how they work. You can create a dynamic interest area by drawing one of the instances of that interest area manually. Whenever you create an instance of a dynamic interest area using the interest area drawing tools, the start time of that instance will by default be set to the current time position in the animation playback view. If the first instance isn't supposed to appear at the beginning of the interest period, then you can use the slider at the bottom of the animation playback view to jump to a certain point within the interest period. You can also use the arrows in the playback controls to step through the trial playback by small increments. The right set of arrows steps through different message events of the trial, and the left set of arrows steps through the trial by small increments. You can also jump to the time point of different trial events by selecting them in the inspector. Once you get to the right time point, you can use the interest area drawing tools to draw the first instance of that dynamic interest area. After drawing it, check the dynamic IA box and give the interest area a label. You can then further fine-tune the start time of the instance if needed, and you can specify the endpoint of the instance. These time points are specified in a manner relative to the start of the interest period. In other words, the start of the interest period is the zero point of this slider. When creating a new interest area instance, you can relate it to another interest area if you like. If you do so, then it will create a new instance of that other interest area with the properties that you specify. Since we don't actually have any other dynamic interest areas in the viewing session yet, we can't use this option yet. After you create the instance, you'll be able to see the interest area in the inspector when you click the interest area set that is associated with the trial. You can do so by clicking the plus sign next to the trial and then clicking the interest area set that will be revealed. Dynamic interest areas are represented by folder icons, and if you expand the folder, you can see all the instances of that interest area, as well as the start time and end time of each instance relative to the start of the interest period. From here, we can use one of the three techniques mentioned previously. First, you can always create new instances of dynamic interest areas manually. If we just have a few instances of each interest area, then this can be a good way to do things. If you're using this method and you want the start time to be set to correspond to an experimental event, then you can jump to that time point by clicking on the event in the inspector. This will align the animation playback view's temporal position with that event. But more importantly, when you create the instance, its start time will also already be aligned with that experimental event. Once you get to the right time point, you can draw the instance, relate it to the appropriate existing interest area, double check the start time, and make sure that the end time is set correctly. Then you can click Enter to create the instance. If your analysis requires a lot of different instances, then the manual creation method might not be the best choice. In order to speed the creation of instances, you can also use one of the copy-paste methods. If you right-click on an interest area and copy it, then you can do a simple paste of the interest area. This will paste the instance so that it has the same start point as the original copied instance. If you move the animation playback view to a different time position and choose Paste Current, then you'll paste the instance such that it has the same duration as the original copied instance, but such that its start point corresponds to the current time in the animation playback view. After pasting an instance, you can hold the Alt key and move the mouse over it to reveal the tools to move or resize it. If you right-click and choose Paste After, then it will paste the instance such that its duration is the same duration as the original copied instance, and such that its start point is immediately after the endpoint of the original copied instance. You can check that by checking its start time against the end time of the original instance. For any of these instances, or for the interest area as a whole, you can check the interpolation option in the inspector. This will make the interest area move smoothly from one instance to the next. The copy-paste methods are great for ensuring precision across interest areas and instances, but it can be a bit tedious if your analysis requires lots and lots of instances. If so, you might consider using the mouse record method, which is often the fastest method for creating interest areas. The general idea of the mouse record method is to play back the trial and use the mouse to define the movement of the interest area as the trial plays back. To use the mouse record method, you can first right-click on the first instance of the first interest area and choose Mouse Record. At this point, the mouse cursor will become a crosshair. You can slow down the playback speed of the animation view and then start the playback. Each time you click, you will create a new instance. It's good to be as precise as possible, but if you make mistakes, it's not that big of a deal. Once the instances are created, you can fine-tune them by changing their properties. And by default, DataViewer applies interpolation to instances of interest areas created via the mouse record mode. This makes them move smoothly from one instance to the next. If you want to fine-tune the properties, you can manually edit them in the inspector, or if you prefer to edit the boundaries visually, you can hold the Alt key and click and drag edges or corners to change the size of instances. If, during the process, you manage to create instances of the same interest area whose endpoints overlap in time, you can use the Cleanup Dynamic Interest Area function to remove the overlap. In cases of such overlap, priority will be given to the instance that occurs later in the trial, so the earlier instances in time will be trimmed so as to coincide with the start point of the later instance. After you have the interest areas configured for a given video, you can apply them to other trials in the viewing session that use the same video. We've already grouped the data by a variable identifying the video that was used in each trial, so we can save the interest area set to disk, make sure to say yes to import the interest area set into the viewing session as a template, and then choose this template as the default interest area set for the group of trials we're working on. This will apply it to all these other similar trials in the group. You can read more about how to work with dynamic interest areas in the DataViewer User Manual under the section Working with Events, Samples, and Interest Areas, Interest Areas.